just what I call myself. And I have a lesson that I must impart to you. It's an old expression, but I must insist it's true.
Grunt Free Press Podcast, your one-stop shop for Saturday morning entertainment. You've had a hard week. Why not sit back and unwind with all your childhood favorites? Felix the Cat, Masters of the Universe, Song of the South, DuckTales, Rugrats, Salo or 30 Days of Sodom, Cheers, Cannibal Holocaust, stock footage of the real Holocaust. By that I mean the Armenian Genocide. We like to keep it light. This is episode 211. Go to www.gruntfreepress.com for the previous ones, because apparently, Internet Archive is flagging these shows as spam now. So, I mean, we had an issue with Internet Archive in the past. InternetArchive.com or org, I think it might be, actually. We had a little run-in with them. So, I mean, I made a fucking donation to them, thinking, like, you know, I mean, what that site does is they preserve, like, old, you know, old fucking games, old shit. This pretty much host people's content they put up. They've been doing that for fucking decades, or you know, at least, like, 10 years, I think. 10, 15 years, just fucking, it's what it sounds like. It's an internet archive of just fucking shit that people throw up on there. You know, they have fucking old games and all that shit. Movies, and I'm like, yeah, again, that site seems pretty cool. Seems like a good organization to have. Yeah, and then they have all these fucking blog posts on the front page from their editors and affiliates virtue signaling about Trump and propping up the awful, like, corporate media, pretty much. I mean, just another one of those fucking assholes. It's the same bullshit here, everywhere else on the front page of their editors' blogs or whatever the fuck. And, you know, then they're vowing to archive, like, every TV appearance that the Trump administration makes so they can fact check them. Which, you know, how that goes. There's, like, pretty much, like, oh, we're going to have this new fucking project we're doing where we're going to, you know, put all Trump shit, like, a special fucking whatever. Like, fucking algorithm or whatever the fuck they were doing. But, I mean, obviously, just completely biased bullshit, you know. It pretty much take 10-second clips and void of any context and twist all that shit around to fit your narrative, as it usually goes. Again, just like anybody fucking else, you know. They're being fucking, like, it's just supposed to be like an archive, you know, but they're being, like, fucking propagandists and taking sides. If you're going to be an online archive, you know, like a library, just do that and shut the fuck up about literally everything else, because this is supposed to be like a neutral platform, you know what I mean? Just read the whole thing, like, fucking how they get away with putting, you know, like, torrents up of fucking, again, old like abandonware DOS games and old arcade games, and there's emulators on there and shit, and just how they get away with it. It's like, oh, well, we're preserving history, and but just nobody, like, questions it. You know what I mean? Because it's fucking just otherwise, like, any other site, like fucking the old ones, like Home of the Underdogs and all that shit, people used to go to for getting old games like that. All that shit gets shut down. But somehow they persevered because they have some kind of clout because they have so much shit on there, other shit. So, and, you know, the validity of that entire project kind of goes out the window when you start putting like personal politics and everything, and have your editors fucking blogging about, you know, taking sides of shit. Like, don't fucking do that. Yeah, we took our donation back. Like, thankfully, they gave it back. It wasn't much. It was, like, $50. Like, fucking, like, I wrote a letter, like, fucking, like, an email being like, dude, this is fucking retarded. I don't like what you're doing. I'm not going to fucking give you money. It's, like, how you spend your fucking donations. But, again, that probably has nothing to do with this show, but I get an error message when I uploaded it last week, and when I clicked on it to upload it, it told me I was a spam bot or something, and if I'm not, like, email them so they can manually review it. Now, this isn't really the most offensive or consequential thing out there, obviously, but I'm not exactly keen on some Silicon Valley faggot who I know like where that company's, like, again, where they lean towards. I'm not, you know, too happy for them to somebody to actually, from Internet Archive, to be actually listening to this bullshit, to be like, oh, okay, I guess it's not spam. Again, right off the bat, it's probably gonna be like, well, we had copyright music, that's why, but it's not something like that, you know what I mean? As they've demonstrated, they will actually fucking, you know, take it out of context and not get it, you know what I mean, and with everything else. So, again, not like there's much to get here, but basically decides, somebody was going to listen to it and basically decided, like, ew, I don't like it, and scrub everything I've uploaded for like the past fucking 4 or 5 years or whatever, you know? And that's why we diversify our portfolio and go to, like, YouTube and BitChute and, you know, Libsyn, the obvious fucking where the audio is going, and so on. I mean, I'm curious to see if this one goes through, if that was just, like a thing or a fluke or something. Who the fuck knows? Like, something I put in, like, the description of last week's show or something. Or if I'm just good, they're just going to fucking, like, block me now. I don't know. But I'm Absolute DSI, by the way. And if you work for Internet Archive, I think you're a spam. What do you think of that? You'll have to email me your social security number to podcast@gruntfreepress.com and send nudes, too. Because I have to make sure you don't have a laser beam cunt or a robotic wang. It's not that anybody actually listens to this fucking show on, like, Internet Archive or anywhere else for that matter. I don't know. It just kind of grinded my fucking gears last week. I'm just fucking like, what the fuck, dude? Like, again, just the routine of I do, like, the same shit after I record it of, like, all right, upload to fucking Libsyn, blah, 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 go to my site, Internet Archive and wherever, Gab and fucking what, and then fucking I go to Internet Archive, it's like, oh, it was just flagged for spam and blah, 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 and this fucking error, and it just pissed me off, especially with them, grinding my Gears 5, not Gears of War 5, oh no, the those madmen did it, just Gears 5, and I don't like it. I understand in casual conversation, most people say, let's play Gears in shorthand, but come on, that's the game's audience. That's there's nothing lamer than a big corporation trying to be hip, you know, Microsoft or Internet Archive, but Gears 5 had a beta or a technical test, they called it, which was available to anyone who pre-ordered the game or his Game Pass. I have Game Pass, so I gave it a whirl. I gave it an Ernest P. whirl. I think this weekend, too, I think they're doing another technical test or beta or alpha, whatever the fuck, that's open to anybody. Like, you don't need to pre-order it or whatever. I think it's going on this week. I'll probably jump into that, too, at some point. But, yeah, so last week I played it, and it's cross-play, so regardless if you were playing on a PC or an Xbox, you could play together. And Gears is one of those games where I don't think it matters very much whether you play with a controller or a keyboard and a mouse. It's not really a game about pinpoint accuracy so much. Like, most of the guns anyway have these massive fucking reticles. It's more about Gears is more about movement and flanking and usually getting in close before you start firing. So what you're losing for aiming with a mouse, I mean, if you're using a controller, you're more or less making up for that with a, you know, if having an analog stick for movement, say more control over that, this is probably a little good. Again, maybe not like an advantage, but it's a wash, I would think. One of these games, too, like third-person action games, I can't imagine that are really movement-based, playing that with a fucking keyboard and shit. That would, I don't know, kill my hands. I'd need a controller to slam on the sticks like I do. You know, I'm playing on PC, so before I even start playing, I want to check my display and my graphics settings for the game and all that shit. And Gears 5 did the thing that pisses me off to no end. Grinds my gears. I already used that one. Instead of giving you a menu to check that shit at the beginning to see, all right, what are the graphics settings or whatever, they immediately throw you into the game and into the tutorial, and even worse, it's like the first fucking scene of the game is just a black screen. So again, I'm going in just thinking like I want to check my settings or whatever, and just like here's a black screen, pretty much like fucking you start it up, and I think the main menu comes up, and do you want to fucking do the tutorial? Like I guess I do if I have to do that to get to my settings. So do the tutorial, and just here's a dark room with fucking like nothing in it. It's just black. I'm like, just fucking are my settings really off, or what the fuck is going on? You're playing, but you're just looking at darkness and. It's supposed to be cute, like it's part of the training, like, you know, the character you're playing's like, hey, you gonna turn the lights on or what? Like, just, dude, don't fucking do that, don't do that at the start of a fucking game, just, you know, just, here's darkness, like, okay, like, I'm just fucking, the first thing you see or not see is you don't see anything, it's like, you know, I don't know what the hell's going on. I don't know if I'm in fucking, like, full screen or what the hell, like, you know, if I had to fucking turn my graphics down to fucking see anything, what the hell's going on? So, you know, there's a little floating robot guy, like, oh, let me fix that for you, and it turns on some lights in the room, but it's still dark, and you can't move, and, you know, it's one of those fucking, like, look up, now look down, you know, is that okay deals with it, checking your controllers, you know, your controller settings, if that's how you want to fucking invert your shit or whatever. I just want to get to the settings like a fucking big boy, so I can just see what the fuck is, what's on and what's not or whatever. I quit out to the main menu, and They do have a benchmark, which, you know, obviously is good. Like, you know, just fucking like a benchmark fucking thing where you can see what your frame rate is and all that, and you fucking run something for like 5 minutes. And I will say, despite bitching about them not giving you the settings up front, I will say the game, it just did like an auto detect and on your hardware, and that did actually very good for fucking, like, it was fine. I didn't fucking adjust anything. It was actually good. I just want to see that shit. You know, it was just fucking just like, you know, defaulted to 1440p, and it just ran fucking stable, 60 frames, full screen, fucking pretty much everything on ultra. So the good old 1080 is still holding up, but still, I mean, again, it was like, oh, the auto detection is really good, but just let me check that shit myself. And granted, it's a beta, but especially because it's a beta, just let me fucking look at what the hell's going on there with the fucking settings. So I do that training section, which is the only single player content there is. Obviously, again, it's just a fucking online beta thing. I'm worried that my fucking gears fears are fully realized in this game, because, you know, in the training, all you're doing is fighting robots, and there's no blood, it's just fucking oil and sparks and shit, fucking, you know, black liquid oil fucking splashing on the screen. It's, you know, PG-13 censored gears, which is where I said the fucking series is going. Oh, that's fucking kind of, it's kind of gay. How far are we falling with that? It's been a while since I played one of these games, because Gears 4 was garbage, and I was having a fucking hell of an adjustment period after playing so much fucking Apex as far as shooters go. Your weapon selection on the D-pad and reloads on the right bumper. Active reload, obviously, if you remember that. Just playing through a little bit in the tutorial, I wasn't really feeling it, and just fucking, like, I don't know, these controls are kind of weird, and, you know, fighting the robots and shit, but the game does run really smoothly, so that's something, you know, I will give it that. Then I jumped into the versus modes, and they have an arcade social playlist that says it's a rolling, changing playlist, but really, it's just an unranked team deathmatch for the beta with a small twist in there, where there are classes of a sort. You know, you can pick different characters, and they're not just like different skins, really. They have their own loadouts and shit. You know, it's like the starting guns, they can have like a Lancer, which, you know, the classic gears fucking chainsaw gun, the hammer burst that does better longer range, and then some kind of SMG or something that obviously does fucking better close range. Then as you're playing, you get kills, you earn points you can cash in for more powerful weapons, and the different characters have different options for those too. So, you know, if you pick like for your character, like a sniper class will have like a longbow, whatever the fuck it's called, long shot, the sniper, the gear sniper will be available at like the highest buy-in. You have the, you know, the most points, it's like 9 points. If you get that, you can buy just buy a sniper rifle and get it immediately. If you have like an SMG, one of those guys, you'll get like a melee weapon, and then another class might just be like, oh, like all your shit's just random, so you never know what the fuck you're gonna get. But, you know, the higher, obviously, you're gonna get better shit. There are also class perks, apparently. Apparently, each character is their own thing they're better at. Like, Marcus can transition to cover faster, but honestly, I mean, I was playing around with it for a little bit, I didn't really notice anything like too drastic per character, like anything too different. I mean, I'd consider that a good thing. They're not crazy different as far as like the stats go. It doesn't like interfere with the basic gameplay too much. You're not worrying about like fucking, you know, hard counters to some character and, you know, team composition or any of that. It's just Gears Deathmatch with a Counter-Strike kind of weapon purchasing layer on top of it. And they're fairly generous with how they count the eliminations, you know, like the kills, the currency to fucking buy in for your better weapons. You know, the things that add up to your purchasing points for you to buy weapons. If you even do like a small amount of damage to anyone that ends up dying by your teammates or whatever, they'll give you a point. So there's no real whining about stealing kills from teammates or any of that gay shit. It's just everybody just fire at everybody, and everyone's gonna get a point for doing it. So that's the arcade mode. This is all right. And then there's two ranked modes, King of the Hill and something else. I don't fucking know. I didn't play that ranked mode too much because those games do last a lot longer than the arcade games. And for the beta, they had like a Tour of Duty checklist you could complete to earn a tester banner and like weapon skins and shit, which I'm just assuming they're going to carry over to the real game. And you know, the milestones for those are you have to win however like five games or whatever. So I was going for like if that's the case, I want to play the shortest games time wise possible to maximize the chance I'm going to fucking win them, obviously, you know. So I kept doing arcade. It's just quicker and fucking earn fucking points or whatever. But from what I played, ranked King of the Hill, it's a more traditional, you know, start. You get, you know, you start off with, everybody starts off with a Lancer and a Nasher shotgun and a pistol and a single smoke grenade. Then, you know, a ring appears on the map and both teams go for the ring and you have to stay in it for a little bit to capture it. Or, if the enemy team captures it, you have to run in there for a little bit to break it, and then, you know, it goes to you, you know, King of the Hill type shit. And you need to control the rings for a set amount of time to win a round, and then it's first team to win two rounds wins the game. So it's pretty much domination, you know, it's fine, it's all right. Overall, I think that the game is fun. That was my takeaway from it. Yeah, it feels very much like fucking old Gears of War. But there's still enough like additions to it to like really justify like what it is. It's not just fucking like, oh, it's just like a better looking like Gears 3 or whatever. It's like, no, this, it feels a little bit different. You know, there's enough new shit in there. Now, the new weapons fucking seem pretty good. I mean, they've like fucking some of the special shit you get. I was getting from like the random fucking buy-ins from that arcade mode. It's like, hey, there's a Lancer with a grenade launcher on it, or there's a fucking missile launcher, or you know, that fucking spiked club that you just fucking run around and just fucking like bash the ground and people explode and shit. It's like, that's pretty good stuff. You know what I mean? This shit's pretty good. And the multiplayer is, you know, as gory as it's ever been. You know, it's not like fucking that tutorial. I'm like fucking like, oh Jesus, here we go with this fucking robots. And like, once you're in the multiplayer, you're chainsawing up fucking people and there's fucking blood everywhere and shit. And, you know, it feels good fucking rounding a corner with the chainsaw revving and getting somebody in the back with it, you know, and just fucking like slicing them up from the back. I'm like, oh, it's pretty good still. Like, this still feels fucking really good and still pretty fucking gory, so that's all right. And the maps seem small again. I mean, there's an emphasis on getting close to people. From what little I played of 4, because it sucked, it seemed like those maps were on the larger side with, you know, there's just too much distance to run between cover, so you'd make a break for it, and then out of nowhere, somebody on the other side of the map would just fucking mow you down. And when you're in fucking like this huge fucking like no man's land areas, it's ridiculous. That's not Gears, you know. The two maps in the beta for 5 were very tight and very fucking close quarters, blind corners. You could fucking sneak up on somebody's side and lay into them from like 5 feet away, and smart sight lines, much better. I mean, I'm on board with the game, I think. Plus, it will be on, you know, Game Pass too, so it's you know, fake free. So you still have to pay for Game Pass. I was like $10 a month or something after like the trial runs out, something like that. But if anything, I'm probably going to keep that and get rid of fucking like Xbox Live. You know what I mean? I don't know. I don't really play. That's only for consoles. You know, it's only for like the, it's like, dude, I don't know. But so I did have like the odd connection issue in Gears where it would infinitely load a map or some shit, or like pop up with a message saying it was taking too long to synchronize my profile. And I would have to like quit the game out completely and relaunch it. I'm sure it's a technical test and they'll say like, oh, you know, that's why we're doing this, to iron those issues out. But those exact types of errors are, I mean, it's like nearly identical to what I seem to get when I play like every fucking Xbox game on PC, whatever you want to call it, Microsoft fucking game on PC. You know, those fucking like syncing pop-ups and that happened in the last Gears. It's happened in all the fucking Forzas I played. Still does it. I mean, last time I checked, whenever I play like Forza or whatever, it's just fucking the same shit. But you know, it's a beta, you know, that's the thing. I played the thing on original Xbox as part of my annual midsummer mini spook fest, my horror game kick. Obviously the game, the thing, is a tie-in with John Carpenter's The Thing, the movie from 1982. The game, The Thing, came out in 2002, and it's a direct sequel to the movie. And they do a decent job of that, too. It takes place a few months or maybe a year or so after the movie. You're a military guy going to inspect the base from the movie in Antarctica, and find out what happened there, and you know, you're going around finding voice recordings and notes left behind from Kurt Russell's character, MacReady. You find Keith David dead with a bottle of whiskey next to him, and you find that the UFO beneath the ice, and like a, you know, the crashed helicopter from the movie and shit. Pretty early, it's like in the early levels that is connecting it to the fucking to the movie. And then it unfolds into a plot about the army wanting to capture and use the creatures as biological weapons. So it's kind of like aliens, you know, the movie Aliens, that type of thing, which isn't something that's not like unfathomable for what like a real thing to script would be like if they made it back then. It's like, yeah, it'd probably be something like this. Like that. That's like where it was escalating anyway. So the beginning of the game is very tutorial heavy too, which isn't a bad thing, but it's a fucking boatload of text you gotta read like right up front, and the game's really not that complicated. There are some systems in place you wouldn't necessarily expect in a game like this. You know, it's a survival horror game, kind of, but I mean, really, it's just a fucking third person shooter for the most part. And it controls a little wacky, I think. Like, I'm trying to think of other games that control, maybe a lot of them did fucking back then in fucking 2002, where all of your movement and the camera control was on one stick, it's on the left stick. And then you use the right stick to strafe, and that's all it really is. And, like, you know, camera, like, you can click it in to go to, like, first person mode and shit. But when you're just playing the game, like, you're not really aiming. You're not aiming with the right stick. You're relying on an auto aim, and it's more or less generous depending on what difficulty you're playing on. Like, that's why it's like easy to see, like, fucking, like, the cone of, like, the auto aim, just like pretty much the entire screen. Then it gets, like, you know, normal's a little bit smaller, and then, like, fucking hard is just, like, right in front of you, basically. I mean, that's the difficulty of the game, is like the auto aim. So, I mean, you can really just fucking run around and fire and forget for the most part. And as long as a targeting reticle comes up, like, you're going to hit whatever the fuck it is. If it's, like, green, you know, if it's just, like, as long as you see it fucking on, you know, like a box around the fucking whatever you're firing at, it's like, yeah, you got to hit it. And then you have a better chance, depending on the weapon and how far you are or whatever. But it's pretty automatic. the more unique features are the cold meter, which goes up when you're outside in the Antarctic weather. And I'd assume you freeze to death if you stay outside for too long, but, you know, if the bar went all the way down, you'd freeze. I don't know, probably, like, start draining your health. It never happened to me. You know, as long as you find, like a cave or a shipping container, any kind of, like, shelter out there, if you, anything, you just fucking, like, walk inside for a second, it warms you up in a few seconds, but, it's a cool touch, literally a cool touch, which makes it so you can't wander around, like, outside forever and just fucking go in this fucking snow and just wander and walk in circles and shit. There's, like, it just makes, like, a timer. It just makes it a little more, adds a little something to it, I will say that. Adds a kind of, like, tension to the exploration. So I did like it that it was there anyway. Then you have a squad with you, and you need them at certain places. You know, there's soldiers that add firepower to you, you know, best at using the weapons and giving you fucking covering fire. And you can get medics that will heal everybody, which is very handy, because you can fucking blow right through your med packs in seconds. And, you know, they can't heal themselves, so it's better off, like, if you have a medic with you, it's just like, oh, the medic's fucking low on health, like, use the med pack on him, that way when you're fucking low on health, like, he can continuously fucking heal you. Then you have engineers who you need to unlock certain doors for you. And if your engineers die, sometimes you'll get a game over, because you might actually need them to fucking, like, progress. Like, you're not going to be able to open the door without them. So you just see, like, fucking, like, oh, the engineer died, game over. So you just have to kind of protect those guys. And yeah, all your squad mates have trust meters. You can do three at a time. So you and the three other people at a time you can have with you. So yeah, they all have trust meters, and usually they won't follow you until you give them a weapon. Then if you want them to help out with the enemies, obviously you need to give them ammo too. It's not like you just give them like a pistol and it's just unlimited, because it's with the fucking AI. Like, you know, you have to like keep feeding him fucking bullets too. And they're ridiculously good shots, so you actually do want to give them fucking like guns and ammo and shit. The only downside to that is they can turn on you. I mean, they'll either freak out if they see too much spooky shit, or they might be infected by the thing virus and they'll fucking turn into a thing that you have to fucking then kill. I think they all end up infected eventually, which is kind of cheap. I mean, they have testing kits in the game that you can use on them. And I've had these situations where, you know, it's just like a syringe or whatever you're supposed to inject, and it'll like tell you if they're fucking infected or not. But I've had these fucking situations where I'd fucking reload a save, and I know it's like, all right, I know this dude's gonna turn like as soon as I do, like, I know he's infected, so I'd use one of the test kits on him. And it's like, oh, no, he's fine. Like, all right, like, the fucking test came back. Like, you know, the vial didn't explode or whatever. So it's like, all right, well, the test kit comes out fine. And then I walk down a hallway, and he fucking just turns anyway. So it's like, yeah, it's just, like, scripted for everyone to die at some point, I guess. Although, I swear I've read there's some kind of like random element to it for who's infected. It's supposed to be different every time you play. So I don't know. But I mean, I was fucking like super careful with it, and it seemed like there was nothing. There's like nothing you can do at certain points in the game. Like at the end of levels, where they just want you to fucking like lose all the squad mates you have with you, they're gonna fucking die or turn or. You'll lose your whole fucking squad to infection, or the base will blow up, or, you know, you're gonna get fucking separated with them one way. It's not like you're taking that group with you the entire game. Like, they're dying, you pick up other people and shit, which kind of sucks if you gave them piles of ammo. You know, it's like, oh, I want to get this guy fucking stocked up, so you give it to him, and then like he's gonna die anyway eventually. Yeah, or you give them a sniper rifle, especially a fucking sniper rifle. It's not a good weapon. Like, it's like you don't want to use the fucking sniper rifle for most of the game. But there's this one part where you absolutely need it to snipe some fucking bombs, and I didn't have one. Like, I'm like, fuck, I'd given like away two or three of them that I had to fucking like the teammates and shit. And then I'm like at this part where you're up in a like a watchtower or something. You have to like snipe these fucking bombs. I thought I was fucked and I was gonna have to like start the game over again, which I had already done, by the way, because I had fucking another Xbox shit the bed on me. But it's another story for another time. But there is one sniper rifle on that level. It's hidden in the back of an otherwise empty fucking like plane hangar, and I'm just like, dude, I was looking for a fucking sniper rifle, dude, forever. I'm just like, I don't think it's in this level, dude. Like, they fucked up. Like, you know what I mean? This sucks. It's like a fucking just. I'm just like stuck here. And then I typed in the thing game, and it kind of auto completed to like, where's the sniper rifle in the thing game? So you know, it's not just me that had that problem. And then I fucking like found like threads from like 17 years ago with people having the same shit. Like, so that wasn't a me thing. It was the thing. So for the most part, you're just running around shooting loads of little monsters, you know, finding locked doors and trying to get keys to unlock them, which isn't always easy to do, to find the keys. So sometimes you need to like shoot out like grates and crawl around in vents and find passwords on computers and solve puzzles and complete objectives. And they have like a fucking like thing, like, where's your objective? Like, your objective is like, go to the medical center or something like that. And it's like, there's no fucking no map to speak of. I mean, the levels are pretty small, but I mean, you have to backtrack quite a bit, and it can be easy to fucking like miss keys, and you know, like sitting on like tables somewhere, a little fucking like shelf with like a bunch of shit, like it's like a bunch of like, you know, containers and vials, and like, oh, there's a key there. Like, you have to kind of like hug the wall and get like the prompt to come up to pick it up. Otherwise, you would never fucking see it. But it's pretty straightforward. I mean, much more action-y than you would expect from a game based on a movie that was about, personal relationships and paranoia and that type of shit. You'll hit a level where they want you to proceed in a very specific order, like, you know, open a door, and then a creature will chase after you. You're supposed to, like, trap them in between doors, and then, you know, get him in a room, because you have like no weapons when you start. Then you have to find a weapon, but you have to give it to like an engineer to get him to trust you enough to follow you, and then have the engineer follow you to unlock another doors and get more weapons. That's that you have one, then you give it to like, you know, other guys or whatever. You know, like activate a turret to hold like some creature in place so you can get to like a key card and so on, like shit like that. You know, it's just like a procedural, just fucking like you have to do this, then do this, then yeah, you just have to play it a couple times and die and like, all right, well, that's I should fucking whatever. So I mean, the puzzle stuff is pretty easy, but the difficulty of the combat encounters can be all over the place. The little things that you shoot, they'll die pretty easily, but anything human-sized or larger, you need to, like, whittle down their health and then burn them with fire. I think Alan Wake may have ripped that off with the flashlight thing. Another thing, you have to juggle between them, between, like, the rifles and shotguns and shit, and then like, all right, now you go back to the flamethrower or a blowtorch, and if you use those to burn like the creatures, that leaves fires on the ground, which they won't it'll stop the creatures from like crossing. Like, they're not, if you have like fire near you, they're not gonna fucking like come at you, but if you walk in it, it's going to hurt you too, obviously, because it's fire. So you have to walk around with a fire extinguisher in your left hand and like whatever weapon you have in your right hand. And then you fucking like, you know, pull the left trigger to spray it. It's like fucking like, all right, fucking stand still, flamethrower, fucking fire extinguisher, like pretty much all the time. Which is, it's a novel idea, but it does get annoying because it's something you have to do that constantly, and you're, you know, pausing the game to fucking switch back and forth between all this shit, you know, normal weapon, fucking flamethrower and whatever. And then, you know, I basically didn't bother using anything else in my left hand except the fucking fire extinguisher because I was fucking using it so much. And that makes you not want to bother with the other items that you could be using, you know, flares and fucking a flashlight and grenades, which are impossible to use because your guy throws like a fucking limp-wristed faggot. And if you're anywhere near a grenade when they go off, you just fucking just die. You just turn into chunks. Like, there's nothing you can do about it. You're better off, like, leaving the fucking fire extinguisher on, you know what I mean? It's just fucking like, I'm just gonna be using this like all the time, so fuck it, you know what I mean? That sucks. You don't really want to go for the other weapons, other items and shit, except for the bosses, where you gotta want to throw every fucking grenade you have and just kind of hope for the best, because the bosses can be fucking like brutal. The first real one that that you face, It's just like a meat blob growing out of a wall. You know, you're just in like a tiny room with them, just fucking you and this fucking like giant thing. And then there's fucking like tentacles coming out of the vents, and these infinitely respawning fucking small creatures attacking you. There must be some kind of glitch too, because he killed me about 24 times there. I mean, that's not the glitch, that's just me playing games. But I'd reload reload right before that, go back to the boss and skip past the cutscene. And as the screen was fading in from black, I'd be getting hit. You know, it was black screen. It was fucking, you could feel the fucking controller rumble. And then fucking, like, as soon as it would come back, like, wait, fucking hell, this is draining. Before I could even see, you know, before I could even fucking, like, move, it's just fucking like, oh, cutscene's playing and you're getting hit. You know what I mean? It's fucking, eventually I found out if you hold back on the fucking, like, movement stick, like, in that black transition, you can get out of the way of his attacks. If fucking otherwise, you're not gonna, it's kind of bullshit. I mean, that first boss is just fucking, like, insanely fucking difficult anyway. And then it's fucking, like, that shit on top of it. You know, every 10 seconds I would have to fucking, like, pause and use a med kit, and there's just, like, no way to fight that fucker, like, gracefully. He's lunging at you as, you try to move to the side, you get out of the way, then there's fucking those tentacles coming out from the wall, they're gonna fucking hit you on one side, and there's the fucking little fucking creature things that swarm you on the other side. And then he has five or six spots you have to injure, like, take that each spot down to zero health to turn it red so you can fucking burn him, like, you know. Then you have to try to set him on fire, and then, like, you have to deal with all that. Now there's fire everywhere on top of it. On top of what you're trying to do, there's fucking, like, fire, so if you walk into that, you're going to get hurt too. So, yeah, it's... you're in this tiny little room where you can barely fucking move. So, you know, I just at some point I was like, dude, I have to just restart this entire level. Like, I just can't keep doing that fucking checkpoint. I just don't have enough fucking med kits. So I was like, dude, I have to start from there. Just be very careful. Like, do the best I possibly can in this level, because I need, like, everything I can fucking possibly get. Yeah, it's just fucking, that's just impossible without fucking spamming the fucking med kits and grenades, and you just kind of just hope and pray that you're not going to fucking die and kill yourself and fucking explode and shit. But, you know, after that first boss, though, it's relatively easy. As long as you have room to move, you can, you know, you face, like, similar bosses afterwards, but as long as the room's a little bit bigger, it's like, oh, I can just move around and it's just, like, fighting anything else. You know, you can keep the creatures at bay with fire, and, you know, don't give your flamethrowers to teammates, by the way, because friendly fire is on, and they'll burn your fucking asshole. And if they walk in front of you and you shoot them, I mean, they tend not to like that, and they start to trust you less for some reason. And they may start, again, they might just start attacking you and shooting you, or just, like, freaking out, and it was, like, fucking going a corner and shake or whatever. So, but yeah, the problem comes in the last levels, when they introduce human soldiers you have to fight. You know, they have guns, obviously, so, you know, they shoot back at you, which, considerably more of a pain in the ass. This fucking is just like, oh man, this fucking just sucks. You know what I mean? It's fucking like, I mean, you know, used to, like, the creatures that have to run up on you and just fucking like, oh, now you got this fucking bullshit to deal with on top of that. it's not bad. I mean, it just turns the game into even more of, like, a shooter than before, than anything else. It's fucking like, I'm just, you know, just shooting enemies or shooting back at me and trying to take cover on that shit. There are some bullshit spawns where you'll clear out a room, and then as you're walking down a hallway, your squad just starts getting shot fucking behind you by soldiers that just fucking, like, must have teleported in right when you weren't looking, like, right when you turned your back to them or turned a corner, just fucking like, oh, all the rooms behind me were clear, but, oh, poof, like, yeah, there's fucking soldiers there fucking firing at my fucking dudes. The bitch is the turrets that are mounted on fucking walls. Just those things fucking, like, drop you in seconds, and they have crazy hit points, and those are pretty tough. And then the entire last level is fucking absurd. You know, it's just fucking these corridors where soldiers are rushing at you with fucking shotguns, and snipers are, you know, shooting at you from a fucking mile away. They're perched up somewhere, and you have to, like, find them as the fucking, like, soldiers are rushing you, like, in this, and you're outside too, so it's kind of, like, timed. You have to rush to try to get to, like, caves and shit. I didn't know if I could fucking like do it. Like it was like one of those, it was that hard where I'm just fucking like, I don't know, dude. I don't know if I can fucking like do this shit. My morale meter was dropping faster than my body fucking temperature when I'm outside in January wearing only black socks because I'm an old man and I like to show the neighbors my flabby hairy tits. And the black socks is something I like to do to start conversations with. But yeah, the thing is fucking, it's tough. I mean, the last section, you really have to fucking memorize where everyone is and just fucking spam the grenade launcher. And you actually have to like use your sniper rifle to, you know, memorize, all right, the snipers are up here and make sure you fucking, you know, get them before, you know, they'll fucking do a shit ton of damage to you, obviously. Yeah, it's hard. And then once you get to the last boss, it's probably maybe the, like the easiest part of the fucking game. You're just like flying around in circles around him. You're in a helicopter, you know, with a minigun, shooting explosive barrels, and like that's it. You shoot like four of those, and that's like the last boss. And that's the thing. That's the thing. Which is, I actually thought it was a pretty good game still. So nice I played it twice again because my fucking Xbox, I had to fucking go buy a new Xbox and start a new game. So I ended up playing it pretty much half the first half of the game twice. But yeah, it's simple action. Simple ball busting at times action. But it's got some good visuals, some good gore, unique setting, and some cool systems in there that do the movie justice. Speaking of justice, I am long overdue for my reparation break, so I'm gonna go do that. Speaking of justice, but not good visuals, Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3, The Black Order, played that. And I will say, the game itself is actually a tad better than I expected. But, unfortunately, it's on the Nintendo Switch. Most of the problems that I have with it boil down to, why the fuck is this a Switch exclusive? Because it looks like garbage. Worse than what would be acceptable for like a last-gen game. Much worse than Marvel Ultimate Alliance 2, which I played not too long ago. I was like, oh, this game looks pretty fucking sharp and good. And like going to this, it's like, this looks like garbage. Like, there's no way. It just looks like crap. There are long loading times and sparse environments. And that Switch controller is not ideal for heavy action games. But there's something there. I mean, it's just hampered by shitty hardware. You know what I mean? It's fucking because it's on the Switch. Even more than the previous two games, I couldn't tell you what was going on with the story there, nor do I really care. I mean, it's just fucking, you know, you're in space one second, then you're in New York, you're jumping around to all these fucking different locations because of Infinity Stones or something. And it's not like Ultimate Alliance 1 where it even that game was all over the fucking map, all over the place, the fucking locations, but at least you could talk to the different characters at length and get some like backstory about why you're there and who they are and all that shit. And it's like, all right, whatever. I mean, you feel like you're learning, you know, like learning something about the fucking universe that you're in anyway. In the Black Order, the NPCs will stand around like save points, like shield access points or whatever, where you save and you switch out your characters. And, yeah, it's just fucking, I mean, there'll be like, you know, three or four NPCs with dialogue bubbles over their head. But you go to talk to them and they only have like a line or two to say, and it's usually some witty quip that really adds nothing of substance to anything. It's just like fucking, like, oh, I don't know, some fucking like Joker bullshit. Some fucking garbage. But, you know, it is an action game, so who cares, right? I mean, it's an action RPG, but the RPG elements are toned down quite a bit in 3. You know, you gain, still gain XP, you level up, but every character's stats are set when you level up, so you can't really control them. Once you hit certain levels, you unlock special attacks, but those are set too. I mean, there's no character specific skill trees to speak of, really. I mean, the only control over it that you have is where to distribute like upgrade points in those four skills that are unlocked for you. Once you unlock them all, it's like, all right, well, I have some points I can put in to make one or the other stronger or whatever. But I mean, eventually it's all going to be fucking maxed out if you level up enough. Yeah, so each of the four powers of like four levels to them that you can fucking put points into, and they'll gain like additional, they'll do more damage or cost less to activate or whatever, you know, just whatever the fuck, just pretty much more powerful versions of the same four attacks, special attacks. But in order to in Black Order to upgrade that, you need ability orbs. And here's where we start to go down the dark path of, I don't know how you gain ability orbs or even how they really work. Because in lieu of the traditional gain some perk points to spend whenever you want system, like if you just, you level up and like, hey, here's some fucking points to distribute each time. They have some almost free-to-play mobile bullshit where it's just a complete mess of like several different fucking currencies to spend on several different upgrade paths, and you're always it seems like you're always fucking loaded with like one type of currency, but you need like another kind, but you don't know how to fucking like get the other fucking kind of like consumable or currency that you need to fucking like do anything. Some of the like the branches don't even like unlock until like late in the game, and there's some kind of crafting system there too, I think. Like I don't fucking, like, it's just like a mess of shit pretty much. The fucking like all the upgrade system works in the game. So here we go. You get coins from breaking open boxes and different, you know, barrels and shit in the levels and killing enemies. You get coins like that. And then you can use those coins to unlock sections of this massive mess of an universal upgrade tree, kind of, as these fucking like hexes. That have, and there's little hexes inside of bigger hexes that are upgrades, and those are passive bonuses. Like, you know, if you unlock it, it's like, oh, well, you have, your whole team will have plus 10% health or +5 defense or whatever. And that's, so it's just like all these tiny hexes that are those unlocks that make up 6 big hexes. And if you fill out one of the bigger ones completely, then it's like, oh, you get like another like bigger bonus on top of that. But in addition to the coins to unlock the hexes, you need ability orbs or some other kind of ability currency, which I think is the same thing as like you're using to fucking upgrade your character's powers, maybe. And the aforementioned currency you seem to get fucking randomly, maybe somehow. Like, I have fucking no clue. Then you've got, it gets better. Then you've got ISO 8, which is some kind of crystal, which I don't know what the fuck that is in the Marvel universe. Maybe it's something that was in like fucking like Avengers or something. I only watched like the first Avengers. Then after that, I was kind of fucking sick of superhero movies and shit. But so ISO 8, it's something you can equip on each character individually. So there are red crystals and green crystals and yellow crystals, rainbow crystals that I think just don't upgrade your stats at all, but they will increase the drop rate of rarer crystals or whatever. But most of those also enhance your abilities, like almost like the same shit that you would be unlocking on like the hex grid thing, like the hex thing you can fucking like unlock. It's like the same type of shit, but it's these character specific things. But then you can fucking like upgrade the crystals as well with other crystals. And there's also like some crystal juice consumable crafting item thing you can get by breaking down crystals, and you need coins for that too. But then you'll also get bonuses based on your team makeup as well. But shit's crazy. There's a lot of fucking micromanagement, a lot of time spent looking at menus and shit. I still don't know what the fuck is going on with most of it, and I've been playing the game for like 20 hours, and I just try to make the numbers go up higher however I can. I don't know why it's like that. Like, I don't know why they fucking decided to fucking make it this ridiculous. Like, again, it looks like some like free to play, like purposefully confusing fucking like mobile thing. It seems like a system that's designed for you to buy consumables or, you know, just like microtransactions to like unlock some of this shit. But there's none. Like, it's not like it is a fucking, it's just like, you know, there's no like buy crystals or buy this or that. It's just, I don't know, this like copied that from a mobile game or whatever, dude. I fucking no idea why it's so fucked up. And maybe because I don't know how any of that shit is supposed to work, but the game is fucking hard. There's 2 difficulties to pick from at first. I'm sure there might be like an even harder one afterwards, but so, normal says, the description is, if you're familiar with action games, pick this. So, I'm like, you know, I'm familiar with action games, you know, but I picked that and playing through a normal, like, dude, it's fucking brutal. It's so hard. I mean, it is a Team Ninja game, and, you know, the studio that made, like, the Ninja Gaiden games and shit, sure. But you'd figure it's like, you know, it's a comic book RPG, and they tell you the suggested levels should be like your character should be, you know, to attempt like different stages and challenges and shit. Like, it'll say like, oh, this is a whatever level 12 fucking stage or whatever. This section of the game is like meant for level 12 and up or whatever, level like 30, you know, there's challenges you do. It's just the same thing. It's like, oh, it should be like a level 30 challenge or something like that. But then I'll go into a stage where all my characters are like 10 levels like over the suggested one, and all my health bar just fucking disintegrates in like two or three hits, like, especially from the bosses. And most of the bosses have like attacks that'll like stretch out across the screen and just require precision timing to jump over their whatever they're shooting, like a light beam, or, you know, dodge their charge attacks and shit. And not only are the Joy-Cons not great for that, and the graphics are bad, and the camera can be a fucking cunt, and it'll be, like, get stuck behind walls and shit, or like not let you see what the fuck you're doing. Not only that, but if you're doing like a special move, like once you start doing a special move, you're locked into that animation until it finishes, and some of them take like they'll take a long time to finish too, like doing the fucking the attack, and you're completely fucking vulnerable when you're doing it, and you get fucked up so fast. I end up fucking like halfway. I'm guessing I'm like halfway through the game. Like, dude, I don't know, man. I can either fucking go back and like do like replay the game like five times and try to like fucking level apparently myself up to like start doing the, like, you know what I mean, not get killed in two hits. But I turned it down to easy. I'm like fucking like, oh, I don't know what the fuck the deal is with me in games lately. It was fucking like, dude, I can't deal with this shit. I gotta turn it down. Still hard. The game is still fucking hard on easy. I found then there are these challenges you can do. And they're supposedly optional challenges, but they're not really, because you get ability orbs and other shit for completing them, and you need all the fucking help you can get. You know, so it's like fucking like, oh, you don't need to do this to like get these extra orbs and like XP, but you kind of do, because it's fucking, otherwise it's ridiculous. You know, it's hard enough trying to get through the game fucking completely. Like, I've played some of them multiple times and shit, again, just fucking like leveling up, and I've even gone back to missions and fucking replayed that. But I think if you were to like skip all that shit and just like, it was like, I'll just go through the story and like not worry about going into like the infinity trials or whatever, and just fucking like, I don't know, dude, fucking just play through the game story mode, it'd be fucking nearly impossible, I think, without those extra upgrades and XP and shit. Yeah, unless like the only way to not really play them, I think, would be to replay from like this, replay the levels over and over to fucking grind, which you know, I still did. I went back and replayed a couple levels, level up myself even more. So, still think it's fucking a hard game, like way harder than it should be. The other thing is, I have the four characters that I'm playing as in my team, they're all like whatever level 40 something. But at this point in the game, that there's no way I can swap anybody out now. Like, you know, if you have like a level 1 character or something that you picked up at the beginning of the game and never used, they're still going to be level 1. They don't auto level when you add them to your squad or anything like that. There are like XP cubes or something, again, another like consumable you can use to like level people. I've just been using those for like my main characters, again, just because I'm like, dude, I need this help to fucking level them up. I give them a couple more levels, a little bit more HP or something, so maybe I can fucking like take down this boss. Yeah, if you had like a level 1 character, you haven't used him, and now you're in like an area that's level 50, you know what I mean? It's fucking like, well, I can't use fucking Hawkeye or some bullshit, because he's, you know what I mean? He's fucking still level 1. Like, what the fuck? He's just gonna die. So, the cast of characters in the game is really impressive, though. That's where the game shines, just the variety of how each one of them plays. I mean, you get the melee-focused heroes, you know, like fucking like Wolverine or Daredevil or whatever. You just have to go in there and just mix it up and get close on enemies, you know, the Hulk and shit. Or then you have, like, you know, ranged ones like Storm or Elsa Bloodstone. Like, I don't know who the first time I've ever fucking heard of her. She's some kind of, like, demon hunter, vampire hunter, monster hunter, or something like that. But I mean, again, it's just fucking, you're just doing your, either playing a ranged character or a fucking, you know, close up melee character, and just fucking spamming your special moves. And the special moves look cool, you know, even if, you know, they're kind of comparable to one another, where you have like an AoE, or you have like a special that'll project damage in front of you, or, you know, another one will do like an AoE, and maybe one you have to like hold down a button or press it really fast for like a continuous attack. And the way it works is you have like, you can just do it normally, you know, like your character just doing their own fucking special attack, and just like hold the right, I don't know what the fuck it even is. I don't like the Joy-Con. It's a little weird. It'd be like the left or the right shoulder to like do it yourself, and it just fucking just go off, and you just do your own thing. Or you press the right trigger, and it'll, you can like team up. We do like a team up attack or synergy attack, which is, you know, if somebody else has a similar thing, and get if like, you know, you have an AoE and another one of your teammates has an AoE, it'll just be like that. You'll do the two of them together or whatever. But so visually, they're all pretty unique anyway. I mean, the basic gameplay loop of the game is fucking, you know, you use your fucking normal attacks, light and heavy, to build up your special meter. And then, you know, you use your special attacks again, trying to, if you do it with like the co-op ones with the other teammates, it'll build up, that'll build up your ultimate attack meter. And then you use like your ultimate on bosses or like big groups of enemies, which is whatever. You press like the left and right triggers together, and then you can press it like multiple times to get more of your team to join in if their meters are full, and you just do like an ultimate attack, which just fucking fills the screen with chaos pretty much, and it does damage. I will say, like, for what it is, like, you know, the fucking ultimate attack, like this ultimate fucking crazy looking thing with those fucking, you know, tornadoes going off and sparks and fire and blah 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 and ultimate, you see like all these fucking shit going on, it looks crazy. Doesn't really do that much damage. I mean, like some fucking, like, it's not even like a screen clear even. Like, you know, there can be some like normal fucking enemies that will like still like be able to withstand like four, you know, like the entire team doing their ultimates at once. It's fucking like, it's like, oh, I do this ultimate. No, well, this kind of like whatever elite version of a normal fucking grunt, like, oh, he's still alive, he's still got a little bit of health, and then, you know, not as, it's one of those, it's weird, like, the way the game is, it's just fucking, like, it's not quite as damaging as you think it would be, or, even things like, you know, like you said, like, you lose health really quick, and then you'll find, like, these health orbs, like, pickups for health orbs, and I figure, like, oh, this will fill me up, like, a quarter of the way or something like that of my HP, but nope, like, just, like, that doesn't, like, heal you as much as you would think, you know, like, the orbs don't heal you as much as you would think they would, the enemies damage you more than you think they would, and, yeah, your attacks don't do as much damage as you think they would, pretty much, and that's where the game's fucking hard, but, yeah, anyway, so you do those ultimate attacks. I think you get, like, random currencies for doing that shit, too, so I don't fucking know. And the game's a bit repetitive, sure, but, you know, it's a branch off of the evolution of a brawler or a beat-em-up, and, you know, that's to be expected, I guess. I mean, on one hand, you could fault it for being mindless, but yeah, at least it's challenging enough that you do have to pay attention to at all times, pretty much, what's going on. You have to pay attention to when you have to fucking roll and dodge or whatever. But even then, even on my best day, like paying attention, dude, it's just so fucking demanding some of that shit of like how often and how precise they want you to be to fucking like dodge like some of those attacks. And once again, you know, you can block too, but blocking, you still take damage. Like, it's not like fucking like, oh, you're not going to get, you're still going to take damage when you're blocking, just not as much, but more than you would think. Yeah, if you don't pay attention at all times, you're going to get fucked up, or I will, because like I said, I'm just having a hell of a time with fucking video games lately. They're kicking my ass. If you listen to fucking older episodes, I mean, it fucking beat Castlevania and fucking Dark Souls, Ninja Gaiden, some of like the hardest, most notorious games ever made. I've gone through like some multiple times on some of them, and just fucking like, I don't know why now a fucking cartoon superhero brawler is kicking my ass along with everything else I play. It seems like fucking just like I was having a hard time in general just fucking playing. Yeah, I don't know what it is. You can give me some tips at podcast@gruntfreepress.com. You can go to gruntfreepress.com and watch my incompetence firsthand and read my diary of slowly degrading gaming skills. I'm absolute deicide. A little short on this last half. I mean, there's still some adjustment period going on here, so bear with me. I'm in a constant state of flux. I mean, fox is what I meant to say. But that's going to do it for this episode. I'll see you next episode. Maybe, I don't know, hopefully I'll be better. I'm not even going to say that. Be better prepared. I say that every week. I'm never fucking prepared. Fuck you. A constant state of flux. That's the title.
the man's heart. When I became the sun, I shone like into the man's heart.